Aloha, fellow travelers, and welcome back to my channel. My name's Shane. Today, I'm going to be taking you through the Google Flights platform. Everybody loves a good travel hack and everybody loves a deal. So today, I'm going to take you through step by step how to use the Google Flights platform, unearth its secrets, use its hidden features to find those wallet-friendly fares and hopefully lead to the trip of a lifetime. Let's take a closer look. So what exactly is Google Flights? Well, Google Flights is an online global search tool provided by Google, and it's completely free. It's designed to give you full control over your search without the marketing spin or influence of the airlines, allowing you to find the best possible flight options for your travel. How it works is that it pulls fares and information from the databases of hundreds of airlines and online travel agents, and then it gives you a whole heap of tools to personalize and filter your search. And once you've found what you're looking for, Google will connect you through to a whole range of booking options to complete your booking, so you can consider it as your one-stop shop for all things flights. Everything I show you today will be for economy fares, but you can easily adjust your search for premium economy, business class, and first class as well. Now, point-to-point searching is what you do when you have a relatively firm date and destination in mind. On Google Flights, start by entering your departure and destination cities in the respective from and to fields. Enter your date of departure and return date, and immediately you start to see that Google Flights is already giving you information on the best prices available. Click on Search Flights and a list of available flights will appear, and this is where the magic starts to happen. So use the filters across the top and the sort button on the right-hand side to narrow down your options. You can filter by price, airline alliances, airlines, stops, departure times, and more. On the right-hand side of each flight listing, click on the Expander button to view more information. In this view, review layovers, duration, and any other features of the aircraft cabin before proceeding. Pay particular attention to any font in red. Before you proceed further, I always recommend that you click on the date grid or price graph in order to see a more dynamic view of pricing across the month. A slight change in your travel dates can sometimes save you hundreds, if not thousands of dollars, especially if you're traveling with others. And the price graph itself is particularly useful for precision planning around holiday times. When you've found the right flight, click on it to make your selection and then repeat the selection process for your return. Google Flights will then present you with a whole range of booking options, which often includes the airline itself. Some airlines do offer additional benefits for booking directly with the airline through their website. This could include advanced seating arrangements, upgrade offers, and advanced meal selection. Another great way that Google helps you save money is by making it really easy for you to search the alternate airports that you might be able to fly into or out of as part of your travel. Google Flights makes it super simple to be able to identify these airports. All you need to do is enter the city name rather than the airport name, and Google will list the servicing airports for that particular city. Again, the cost savings here can be huge. And this feature itself isn't bound by geographic location either, so you can use it to search up to 5 airports, regardless of where they might be. Personally, I use this quite a lot when I'm looking to book my trips, looking for bargains when I can turn bucket list destinations into a reality. Throughout your search, Google Flights will continue to provide you with analytics and data in order to help you make the best decisions. Price history is a great example of this, with Google Flights showing the average price over a date range and really helping you hone in and identify whether you found a bargain or whether you're actually overpaying. But if the travel gods aren't working in your favor, Google also has a solution for that too. You can track prices across a particular date range, find out when prices change, and also learn when a fare is about to expire. You can do this by signing into Google and be notified by email directly into your inbox. If you've been bitten by the travel bug, Google's exploratory searching is phenomenal. We'll start off by doing a blank destination search. All you need to do is enter your departure city or an airport. Enter your dates, but leave the destination blank. And voila, now you have an interactive global map to explore. You can drag the map to zoom in and zoom out to explore different parts of the world and see the fares that it's going to cost to get you there. Just adjust the filters on the left-hand side to sharpen your results. Adjusting the price filter here can really help you visualize just how far your money can take you. Another great way to harness the power of Google's exploratory searching is to do a whole country or whole continent search. In the where to field, simply enter a country rather than a city as your destination and Google will map the fares for you. Now we can also take that to the next level with a whole of continent search. And all you need to do is enter in the continent name in the destination field and Google will pull back the best fares across the entire continent for you. So if you're planning a big trip to multiple destinations, like a big European trip, you can easily see how Google's going to save you money. And finally, for all you dreamers and flexible travelers out there, if you just want to be taken away, simply leave both the destination and the dates fields blank. Refine your search results by adjusting the filters on the left-hand side. Google has your back here again. You can target particular months or even weekends over a period of time. And just like that, our tutorial today on Google Flights has come to an end. If you've liked today's content, please make sure you hit and smash the like and subscribe button. And if you've managed to use the content today or managed to use the Google Flights platform to find or book the trip of a lifetime, please make sure you comment. Tell me a little bit about how much you've saved or where your trip has gone. I'd love to know. And keep an eye out for some incredible trip reviews coming up. I'll be traveling first class through to not so first class, but looking forward to taking you along on all those journeys as well. Until then, goodbye.